Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, hi, my name is Katie. I'm an author and an editor. I have 6 books out currently. My 6th book, Wicked Souls, just came out on December 7th. And for today's video, this has been requested honestly for years now on my channel, and I've just now getting around to filming it. That makes it sound like I just haven't done it yet, but I've been kind of putting it off because there's just so much to get into that I've been kind of overwhelmed by the idea of making this video. So we took some notes. I'm going to be talking about my decision to go the self-publishing route rather than traditional publishing, and then also just kind of briefly touch on the pros and cons and both of them just in general. To be totally clear, I am not an expert. I'm literally just sharing my experience, my reasoning, and I'm gonna put in my 2 cents for my advice if you're trying to decide for yourself. I have self-published 6 books now, and I have my own freelance editing company, so I work with a lot of other indie authors. And I work completely for myself now with my editing and my writing, and I majored in creative writing in college, so that's kind of the background that I'm coming from. I have a whole video on how I started my editing company and got into all of that. If you're interested, I'll link it down below. But that's not what we're talking about today. We are talking about why I chose self-publishing. I feel like inevitably I'm gonna forget something. If you have other questions, feel free to leave them down below in the comments. And thank you so much to Skillshare for sponsoring today's video. If you're just now dipping your toe into editing or writing or publishing, I think Skillshare would be a great resource for you. They have classes of all different kinds of topics. They're an online learning community, so you could take art classes, design classes, business classes, but then you could also take writing, editing, publishing, how to format your books. They have a video basically on every part of the process, and I think they would be a great place to start if this is all new to you. They're super affordable, and my link will get you a 1-month free trial, so definitely check that out if you're interested in trying them out. I've literally been using them for years. I have tried so many of their classes. They have like really cool teachers for some of their classes too. There was one on like characters that I took that was taught by Saba Tahir, who wrote the An Ember in the Ashes series, if you've read that. But they have some really interesting teachers on there too. So yeah, make sure to check the link down below in my description if you want to get a free trial. Highly recommend. And other than that, let's just get straight into the video. So, okay, just in case you're new to my channel, let me give you like a really brief rundown. I self-published my first book in 2018. That book was called The Sweetest Kind of Poison. It's a collection of poetry. And at that point, I had no idea what I was doing. Like, absolutely no idea. I've had my YouTube channel since then, so there's videos of the whole process if you want to take a trip down memory lane. It's cringy. I wouldn't recommend it. I was still in college at that point, and this was a collection of poetry I had put together. One of my viewers actually designed the cover for me, and I was like, hey, I'm just gonna self-publish this over the summer for fun. Never thinking that I was gonna continue self-publishing. I thought this was gonna be a one-off thing. So I used one of Amazon's free ISBN numbers. I formatted it myself in Word, and the rest is history. So I have since come a long way since then, and then I really decided to dive into self-publishing after I graduated college. So there's a pretty big gap between that first book in 2018, and then my next book didn't come out until June of 2020. That was my first novel. That's the Anti-Virginity Pact. And so for this book, I had a very different process. I set up an LLC, I started my own company, I bought my own ISBNs. This is actually the new cover, so I did go through a cover change with this first book. I put this book on NetGalley, I got ARC readers. I like really tried to. This was not a for fun project. This was like a business move for the first time. So I really had my mindset shift with this book. And then in October of 2020, we had Poems for the End of the World come out. In March of 2021, The Anti-Relationship Year came out. In August of 2021, The Marionettes came out. And then now in December of 2021, Wicked Souls just came out. So that's my backlog with the books. So the question I get like the most often over the years has been, you know, why did you self-publish? And there's just not a good simple answer to that, and I feel like everybody has their different reasons, but what it comes down to is self-publishing aligned with my goals for my career. Originally, when I was in college, like I said, I was majoring in creative writing, my plan had been to go into traditional publishing as an editor. So then things changed, and I graduated college, and I started my own company instead. The primary reason I went the self-publishing route, I feel like, was because I wanted to work for myself and I wanted to have my own business. That's something I've wanted for a long time, but it was always like, I liked the idea of that, but I didn't know like what kind of business I would have. And I've always been a writer, and I don't know why it took me 22 years to realize like that could be one thing. Like, you could have a business that is your writing. And that was really the main appeal of self-publishing to me. So apologies in advance if this is really disorganized. I'm just gonna start going through my notes. So some of the pros and cons that I considered. For one thing, I think the most widely talked about pro of self-publishing is your control over the end product of a book. This also, though, I think is a pro and a con. pro if you really care about what your cover looks like and you want to be able to pick that. You want to be able to pick your audiobook narrator. You want to be able to pick your editor. You want to choose the formatting. You want to be able to choose all of those little details. This is great. It can also be really overwhelming because now all of a sudden all of these different decisions fall on you. You also have control over your publishing timeline. And so this was a really, really attractive pro for me, because if you're familiar at all with traditional publishing, it is incredibly slow at all points in the process. So even if you manage to get out of the query trenches relatively quickly and you land yourself an agent, you're still editing with the agent, and then you're, you know, going on submission and trying to find an editor. And then, so it's like years will pass before the book actually comes out, for one thing. And then even if you land a good deal and you're gonna have some more books coming out, you're still most likely going to have one book come out per year max. And as someone who is publishing 3 or 4 books a year right now, it would drive me crazy to only be able to publish 1 book a year. I get to set my deadlines, I get to pick my release dates, I get to decide how many books I'm gonna publish in a year, and that's something that I really, really like. And then not only with being able to set the own timeline, there's just so much freedom and flexibility for you to publish whatever you want. Now, kind of like with the first point, this is a pro and a con, because you're gonna have to make some marketing decisions and some business decisions in regards to this. You know, are you gonna do pen names? Are you gonna stick within one genre? Are you gonna genre hop? Whatever you choose is whatever you choose, and you're gonna have to deal with what comes with that choice. One of my primary goals with publishing was I wanted to write the books that I wanted to write, love what I was writing, and just have complete control over it, and being able to put out as many books a year as I want. If I want to put out 4 books this year and 1 book next year, I could do that. If I want to put out 2 paranormal books and 2 contemporary books and 2 poetry books, I can do that. Whereas if I had been traditionally published, I am willing to bet no publisher out there would have put up with what I have been doing. Like, my first book was a poetry book, and then I did a young adult book, and then the companion to that young adult book is a new adult book, and then I did another poetry book, and then I did a paranormal steamy vampire book, which is a series now. So I have just, like, I would have been hell for a publisher to deal with. Like, there's no way I would have been able to do what I've done in traditional publishing. There's just no way. Would that be for the better? Would my career be growing faster if they had forced me to stick to a genre? Maybe. Would I be happy? No. Speaking of series, also having the ability to finish a series was really attractive to me. If you get a book deal for book one, there's no guarantee that you're gonna get to continue that series. So when you're pitching the first book in a series, it has to be able to stand on its own as a standalone. So considering my books have cliffhangers and definitely can't do that would be bad. And then if your book doesn't sell enough, the publisher might not pick up book two. You might not be able to finish your series, and then suddenly you have to scramble and fit the last 4 books that you had planned into one book. I like having complete control over how many books my series ends up being, regardless of sales numbers and all of that kind of stuff. Going back to the timeline with traditional publishing and how slow it can be, something that I've really loved about self-publishing is being able to publish at my own pace and everything. But because of that, I feel like I've been able to grow my career a lot faster because I've had more control over it. So I've been able to go full time with this a lot faster than I think I would have been able to with traditional publishing. If I had been publishing like 1 book a year, I just really, really doubt that the advance on like 1 book would have been able to tide me over. Like, I'm able to come up with like creative solutions to help supplement my income in order to be able to do this full time. Like, I sell the signed copies on my website and I've been publishing consistently. I can run a sale randomly if I decide that I want to do that. I can change the covers and rebrand a series to try and breathe more life into it. Like, I can do whatever I want. With traditional publishing, I just feel like it would have been slower going. I probably would still be working a full-time job. I just really like that with self-publishing, it's allowed me to go full-time working for myself pretty quickly. I'm 25 and I've been working for myself, I don't even know, I have no concept of time. I started my business in 2019. I've been working for myself full-time since September of 2020. I also personally just really enjoy the business side of it. I like having the freedom to put my books on sales and set up my own ads and, you know, change my covers. I like being able to make all of those decisions for myself. I like working with my editor and hiring my editor and working with my cover designers and coming up with new ways to market my books. I like having to do all of that. To some people, that's a con. They look at all of the work that they're gonna have to do and they're gonna be like, I don't wanna do that. I just wanna write the books and let other people deal with the rest. And that's totally cool. But self-publishing is probably not for you then. I like everything falling on my shoulders. I think this stems from, you know, me being the kid in high school that, like, when there's a group project, I'd rather just do it all myself because you guys aren't gonna do a good enough job. So I like that I have control over everything. Another pro is you typically make more money in self-publishing per sale. I mean, if you're traditionally published and you got the big bucks and you got like a great advance, probably not. But per sale, the royalty is most likely larger and you don't have an advance that you have to earn out. So you start making money from every sale immediately. And then also you have like the longevity of sales and you don't have to worry about like print runs and things like that. With a print on demand company, you know, someone orders the book, they print it that day and then it goes out. With traditional publishing, usually they'll have like a certain number of copies of books that they will print. Your previous sales history won't stop you from publishing more books. You know, if you have a book perform poorly, pick yourself back up, move on to the next one. With traditional publishing, that can hurt you. It doesn't necessarily mean you are doomed, but it could be a challenge for you. And then also, old titles can pick up at random. This is true for traditional publishing too, but I feel like the shelf life of a traditionally published book is shorter than indie published books. In the majority of cases, you know, you see indie books all the time that were published like 10 years ago that are just now starting to get traction and blowing up. With traditionally published books, they really look at the release week and then the first year of the book being out to kind of gauge how successful a book is. Whereas I had a book, like I said, come out in 2018 and then it started doing incredibly well in 2020. In its first year that it was out, from, I think it came out like towards the end of August, so August to the end of the year. My channel was a lot smaller at that time. Again, I said I just did it for fun. I did zero marketing for that book. I probably sold like 200 copies of that book in its first calendar year. And now it has sold so much more than that. So I like that there's not this pressure to like perform in a certain period of time. I can have a book from almost 4 years ago now randomly become my bestseller. And then, like we kind of touched on earlier, the ability to refresh your books, this kind of also goes with, you know, being able to keep your book selling over time. You can do a cover change and rebrand if you want to try and bring in some new readers. You can put it on sale. You could randomly release a novella. You can literally do whatever you want. I feel like I'm talking in circles and just keep coming back to the same thing. You just have control over everything and you can do whatever you want to do. And so for me, that's a pro. I like having that freedom. But as I said before, you have the freedom to make all of these choices, but that also means you have the freedom to make the wrong choices, and it's no one's fault but your own when that happens. So now, that's a great segue. Let's talk about some cons. Self-publishing costs. When you're traditionally published, you should not be paying any money to get your book published. You give a percentage to your agent, but your publisher is giving you the advance. You were not paying them to publish your book. When you're a self-published author, all of the expenses fall on you. You don't have a publisher paying for your editor, paying for your proofreader, your cover designer, your formatter. You are paying for everything, which can get incredibly expensive, especially when you tack on, you know, the marketing costs and everything. And then it can be slow to make that money back if your book doesn't like really take off right when it releases. So then it's difficult to keep publishing because you have to keep pouring in all of this money into the next book before you've even made back money on the first book. So costs is a very, very real obstacle for self-publishing. I have videos on how much my three most recent books cost to publish if you're curious about my specific numbers. But yeah, that can be challenging for sure. Also, all of the marketing falls on you for your books. This is also kind of true, to be honest, with traditional publishing. Unless you like are their lead title, odds are you're gonna have to do the majority, if not all of your marketing yourself anyway. But with self-publishing especially, you will have to find ways to market your books, and it's an ever-changing landscape. Like, the ways in which you market your books, the ways that are successful, it changes constantly, and you have to keep up with that, and you have to be willing to try new things. So you really do have to wear a lot of hats. You have to be your own marketing director and your own bookkeeper and your own everything. The next con isn't something that was personally a con for me, but if this is one of your goals, then it's something to consider. If you're self-published, there's no guarantee that your book is going to be in physical bookstores. So if something that you really want out of your career is to be able to walk into a Barnes & Noble and see your book on a shelf, that's far more likely with traditionally publishing. I've seen my books in physical bookstores though. I've seen my books in physical libraries, which is really cool. I love when that happens, but it's not like a widespread thing. Typically, my books show up in bookstores if one of the booksellers or one of the librarians follows my channel, and they were fantastic and they ordered my books. Thank you guys so much if you're watching this for doing that. Or if I have my viewers or my readers go to their local bookstores or local libraries and request a copy of my book, that's typically when my books show up there. They don't just automatically show up there. Another con is there is still this negative connotation around self-publishing. People still look down on it. And this is something that honestly I have grappled with. Not everybody. I do feel like the attitude towards self-publishing has improved over the years, but self-publishing is also technically easy. Anybody could do it. You could write something, you could upload it to Amazon, and you could publish it today. Self-publishing, well, is not easy to do, but there are plenty of people out there who do just upload these books that aren't edited, aren't formatted, don't have good covers. And so people see these like low quality works and then kind of assume that a lot of self-published books are the same way, which is honestly fair. If you've paid money and then gotten burned by like a book full of errors and stuff, obviously you would feel ripped off. But yeah, there are definitely still readers who have straight up to my face said, or like over social media to my face, like, oh, I don't support indie books, I don't like self-publishing, and like they won't read self-published books. And there's traditionally published authors who don't really see you on the same level as them. Not everybody. Some people are lovely, but there is still that little bit of a divide. And there are still some people who are gonna look at you as a self-published author and be like, oh, so you're not a real author. Like, oh, so you weren't good enough to be traditionally published, instead of, oh, you chose to do self-publishing for all of these different reasons. It wasn't like a backup plan. It wasn't, oh, I couldn't get traditionally published, so I guess I'll just self-publish instead. It was, I weighed the pros and cons and this fit better for me. Oh, my next bullet point, we just talked about it. It's easy to not do it well. Everything falls on you. And so this can be really overwhelming with your first couple of books when you don't even know what you should be doing. You don't even know all of the steps yet. So it can be overwhelming to figure out everything. And if you make a mistake, it's on you. No one else is gonna hold your hand through it. Another con, self-publishing for most people, some lucky people take off with their first book, but for most people is a long game. It is a marathon. You are often not going to be a bestseller immediately. You're oftentimes not going to be making a full-time income immediately. It's commonly talked about in the indie community, the number one thing to do in order to do this full-time, in order to sell more books, is to have a backlist, which means you need to publish lots of books. Now, that doesn't mean you need to like quickly publish a book every single month and they're not ready, they're not great quality. It just means it might take a while until you've published quite a few books, until your career really starts to build on itself. And I've definitely actually seen this to be true with my most recent book release, Wicked Souls. It's the second book in a series. And when this book, the first book in the series sold really well when it came out, but when the second book came out, I really saw sales for the second book and then also the first book really pick up the pace, and I'm kind of hoping to see that with, you know, future books in the series as well. So the best thing you can do to sell the books that you already have out is to release a new book, because then someone reads the new book, oh, they love it, they're new to you, they want to go back and read all of the other books that you've done before. So then the more books that you have out, the more that they have to go read. So backlist is king 100% with self-publishing. So those were all of my notes. To recap, I really chose self-publishing because I wanted to have my own business, and I like having complete control, not just over the end product of the book itself, but my career and my deadlines and my publishing timeline and how many books I can publish and which books I can publish. And if something's not working, I can try something new, and I just have complete control over my career. I have complete control over the books themselves, and it's fun. And I like being in charge of everything. It's stressful at times. I make wrong calls sometimes, but I would still prefer it 100% over anything else. If you are trying to make this decision for yourself, my advice to you would be to really be honest with yourself on what your goals are with your publishing career, and also be real with yourself and be honest with yourself about your personality and your capabilities. Don't feel bad about that. If you're someone who's like, I don't want to have to do the business side of things, that doesn't have to be a bad thing. If that's not in your personality, if you feel like you won't be able to do all of the business side stuff, that's okay. But I do think it's important to be upfront with yourself at the beginning Is it important for you to be in physical bookstores? Is it important for you to have control over everything? Do you feel like you are in a financial position where you can afford to invest all of this money into these books? And I don't want to say that you can only self-publish if you have a lot of money to be able to publish the books. Plenty of people publish on a very small budget, and then once the books start to sell, maybe they'll go back and they'll get a new cover and like things like that. The best thing you can do is to research both of your options as much as you can, so you know exactly what you're going to be getting into, and then make a list of your goals and what you want to get out of your career, and then figure out which one fits better. To give you an idea, I have 3 books come out this year, but then I also was getting covers made for books that'll be coming out in 2022 and stuff like that. And then also some of my expenses go for my YouTube channel and also for my editing business. But I spent about $12,000 on business expenses this year. So it can be quite expensive. Okay, and lastly, in my previous video, I asked if anyone had any specific questions for me to answer in the video. So let me see. Is it a hindrance if the first book we publish is very long, 100 or 120K? I know this is genre specific, but let's say we hit the top mark of the particular genre. If you're trying to get traditionally published, this might be a challenge because sometimes agents don't want to take on super long projects by new authors. But if the book is well edited and it's not like overly long, I think books should be as long as they need to be. I don't really think readers care about that. I don't think they would like see a super long book and be like, oh no, I'm not gonna read that. I don't think most readers even pay attention to that when they're buying a book, to be honest. Someone asked, I'm curious why you decided to go for more general book titles that already exist after choosing very original titles for the packed novels. Do you think it could potentially have some negative effects? So she's talking about Wicked Souls because there's plenty of books with the title Wicked Souls. I'm not worried about it personally. I feel like The Marionettes is a little more of an original title, and that's the first book in the series. So that's where you have to start the series from. And if you read the first book and you liked it and you want to read book 2, I think you're going to read it no matter what the title is. I don't think people are specifically searching for book 2. There are 1,000,001 books out there and tons being published every single day. So it is hard to find a title that hasn't already been used. I do try to come up with fairly original titles for my books. It is something that I strive for, but like I said, there's so many books out there, it is quite challenging. Could it potentially have some negative effects? Yeah, if someone's searching your book title and a million other books with the same title pop up first and they can't even find yours, that wouldn't be great. Like I said, I feel a little bit better about it being the second book in a series. And then I think the rest of the questions we covered with everything else we've already talked about. So hopefully this was helpful. Thanks so much for watching. I'll have all of my links down below in the description if you want to check out my books. Maybe subscribe and stick around if you're new. And I will just see you guys in my next video very, very soon. Bye. No. Pretty Caroline, oh, 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 stone cold stunner. She wants-